Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome. The moment is finally here, and our entire team is bursting with excitement to share this performance with you all. So yes, I have dressed up for the occasion, but this hour is all about you. This is a celebration of people of all ages and from every corner of the globe coming together with a shared purpose. To make music, to feel a sense of togetherness, and to recognise the feeling of satisfaction and fulfilment that comes when you have invested time and effort into something. You have all worked so hard and we have all learned so much. And hours of music making have been experienced, enjoyed and agonised over in our newfound virtual space. Both breakthroughs and disappointments have been experienced, the highs and lows of resolving to stay on that path of improvement have all been felt. It is always easier to give up, to slow down, to say, maybe tomorrow I'll try. Purely by signing up to this workshop, you all showed will, energy, a dedication to improvement, a love for life, and of course, a deep love for music. So I know there are thousands of you with us, and I know that you are from all over the world, but it's kind of mind-boggling to get my head around it. So I wondered if you guys could actually just tell us which country you're from.
Spain.
England. India.
Greece.
South Africa.
Northern Ireland.
USA.
Japan.
Russia. Siberia.
Malta.
Romania.
China.
Canada.
Australia.
Romania.
Guernsey.
Northern Ireland.
Deutschland.
Albania.
The Netherlands.
USA.
Singapore.
Namibia.
Bit Scottish and English.
Malaysia.
Ireland.
Singapore.
Malta.
Mexico.
Sri Lanka.
Canada.
Fraser.
Brazil.
Wales.
Colombia.
Portugal.
Alaba.
England.
Philippines.
Kuwait.
Romania.
From Canada.
Scotland.
Now it is time to announce our first mass performance of the day. I am unbelievably excited. Now I am aware that not everyone could or wanted to send in a video, which is totally understandable. It is not easy to record yourself. But we've designed this concert to allow for as much participation from you at home as possible. We will leave space before every single piece to allow you to get ready so that you can get your instruments prepared and play along to us.
Drum roll on the belly, drum roll on the belly.
Now on to our very first piece of music. This has been recorded for all of you, analysed, picked apart and taught masterfully and relentlessly by our incredible intermediate team tutors, Alex, Rachel, Ruth, David and Stuart.
Well done, all of you. I'm going to miss you so much. The Mattachins is just so fast and so exciting. The swords were flying.
Hi guys, it has been so much fun working on this piece with you. Enjoy it and good luck.
Cellos, it's been so great to work on this piece with you. I'm so proud of all that you have achieved. Well done for keeping up with the speed of it and I can't wait to hear it.
Hey everyone, I have loved working with you all on the Warlock. Thank you so much and sorry if we took it a little bit fast. It was quite quick, wasn't it? But so impressed that you all rose to the challenge. Amazing work, guys. Well done.
Guys, I've had so much fun working with you all. I'm going to miss you lots and lots. Good luck, go for it, and enjoy.
Mattachins makes me feel excited because it is a fast piece and it is a fun piece when you are still learning. I love that Mattachins makes me want to be in another world. I imagine I am in a sword dance and my bow is my sword. And now we're going to hear our performance of Mattachins from the Capriol Suite by Warlock.
Thank you.
think that was hands down the best performance ever of Mattachins by Warlock. I have been watching so many of you practice this piece over the last 3 weeks, and I'm just so proud of the results. I hope you enjoyed that. It just didn't last quite long enough. So I'm sure you can all only imagine how many things have been funny or gone wrong over the last 3 weeks, and how many of them have been caught on camera. So we just thought we can't let this concert go by without sharing just a few of those nice moments and a few of those when things go wrong moments. So please enjoy the next few minutes.
Ahoy, lads and lasses. I'm Captain Charlie, as you can see.
I'm Minnie Mouse today.
My name is usually Yume, but today it's Ratty Yume.
So Snow White in all her glory. Yeah, I think we're the best team. Who else thinks that?
Hello. How do you do the plucking without touching another string? Because I do that in bar 65 to 68. What is your favourite dessert?
All together!
Ah. To do it a little bit faster. Thumbs up for faster.
Oh, it's gone off.
Well, I need to know whether it has actually recorded that.
Use the hashtag.
Beginners with Bob.
I know. Send me your clips using the hashtag Bob Beginners with.
No! Why did you turn into Yoda?
Thanks. Exasperated. Okay, I'm starting this again.
Thank you everyone so much for joining us this afternoon.
I am trying to unmute you, Rosie. I'm so sorry.
Oh wait, I've got it.
Falling out from 10, don't give up, is number 9.
I'm just gonna say 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and you can go whatever you want. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1.
Okay, let's do it separately. You do all your bits and then I'll do it in my own time. Oh, this is just gonna be a full blown domestic. Oh, right.
Okay.
Impossible to play in tune with myself. Impossible.
On the something warm ups? On the I'm gonna say a preview channel there.
No,
I'm gonna write
no,
that down.
Warm up playlist.
It's just I just came out of my head. And on our warm up playlist. Why can't I say that? Why can't I say warm up playlist? Right.
I've just spent an hour recording my next tutorial. And firstly, my head is chopped off for the entire thing.
That wasn't recording that whole time. Our foundation is dedicated to uniting and inspiring those who believe that creative and artistic things are essential to a great education. Donations alone have allowed us to make this 3-week workshop possible, and in fact this very film possible. So we would like to say an enormous and sincere thanks to every single person who has donated to us. Further donations, however, are always, always welcome. We intend to put on many more workshops like this one and can do more and do better with your support. You can donate via our website or by clicking the link below. There are a small number of individuals, trusts and foundations who we would like to say an additional thank you to for their belief in our vision
and allowing us to make this happen. I'd also like to say a personal thank you to our Board of Trustees for their support and faith in us.
Now we're going to move on to the Tchaikovsky Souvenir de Florence final movement. This piece is incredibly difficult. It's layered with six different voices, two violins, two violas, and two cellos, and it is extremely intricate. All sorts of parts accompanying at different times, moving at different times. There's also a central moment, which is a fugue. The main theme is played first, then that same theme comes in a little bit later, then the same thing happens again and again and again. So you have all of these layers of the same theme and counterparts all going at once. Now to play that when we're in situ physically together is already a challenge, but to try to do that in isolation was an experience and a half for all of us. Now we have put the Tchaikovsky out to students and to more advanced learners to also send in videos and be integrated into our playing. We've given direction to them to be as absolutely fearless as possible because our experience was one of caution, trying to make things line up, dealing with the concerns and restrictions that so many musicians are experiencing during this time. We have asked them to be bold, to bring extra expression to our performance, to bring more colourfulness to our performance and extremities. We have been so impressed and moved by these videos and can't wait to share the result with you now. clapping along with everyone.
So guys, if I could leave you with one last thought, it would be this. Stay curious. Continue to stay interested in things. If you see something that catches your eye, explore that. Go down that road.
Never doubt yourself and remember those two P's, patience and persistence.
Always, always, always be yourself.
Always, always, always come back to the story.
My golden takeaway has to be the words of Zoltan Kodály. Develop a well-trained ear, mind, heart and hand.
Find the bits you really love in the music and just play them loads. Go for it. Play it with all your heart.
Have a desire to always want to push your musicianship. It's the bedrock of being a holistic musician.
If I was to give you one pearl of wisdom, it's always let your ears guide your fingers.
Find your musical community. It's the place where we get motivated. It's the place where we get our community. It's the way we make friends. It's the way we feel supported and inspired.
Good luck comes from hard work. The harder you work, the luckier you'll be.
To be consciously grateful and mindful and thankful to each and every seemingly invisible person who works towards putting on any piece of art.
Keep going. If it's a bar or a super exciting ambition that you've got, keep going. Keep going. You will get there. Trust me.
I thought I'd share with you the three L's, what I'd love you to do. So the first thing is to listen to music. Learn as much as you can from music and from other people. And just remember to love it.
To be a listener. Listen to the musicians that you admire and go to concerts and try to take everything in.
So our Paganini journey had many, many different strands. The wonderful Ayoub sisters wrote an arrangement for all the orchestras, the advanced, the intermediates and the beginners. Our objectives were to address important technical skills with each variation, to allow us to coach through the 3 weeks ways of addressing through music those difficult technical skills, but also to create characters with each variation and to inspire the imagination as we delved into the weird and wonderful, incredible world of Paganini. Masters of the violin were kind enough to record a variation of the original Paganini's 24th Caprice.
I can't express my gratitude to each and every one of these violinists for not only taking the time to record the variation, but also to teach us something about how they feel towards Paganini or how they feel towards that particular variation. The whole process has been fascinating and extremely educational for me and for so many more of us. And so I'm incredibly excited to share with you now this version of Paganini's 24th Caprice.
Thank you. Also wanted to embrace improvisation, a fundamental key to developing the brain generally, but also developing confidence and freedom in music making.
Hey folks, I'm so excited. We're coming up to the performance. We're going to hear whether I'm any good or not, whether I've managed to motivate, inspire you in your improvisations. It's we're all going to see. Whatever happens, remember, mistakes are cool. Bye.
But we also, of course, wanted the whole family to get involved. And for that, we turned to one of life's most earthy qualities, rhythm.
Hello, guys. How you doing? Patrick King here. Hope you're having as much fun as we all are at the Benedetti Sessions. Come and get stuck in. This is a bit of percussion fun for everyone.
So you can get involved in this concert too if you're at home. If at any point you see this signal and a counting, one, two, three, four, you need to play this rhythm. I would like a drink, ho! One, two, three, four. I would like a drink, ho! If you see the second signal, a point, it's a chance for you to play whatever you want for four whole beats. So you'll see this in a counting. One, two, three, four, play!
And now, for those of you planning to play along with us from home, now is your time to get your instruments and get prepared. Those of you who are playing along with old percussion, now's the time to get ready. We are about to hear the one and only very first performance of the mass arrangement, mass collective that is the Paganini's 24th Caprice arranged by the Ayoub sisters. Enjoy.
Thank you.
The sessions have been like for me. There've been some sleepless nights, bit of pressure, sometimes a wee bit stressful, loads of fun, a lot of learning and a lot of music. But I'm just wondering, could you guys tell me what the sessions have been like for you?
Amazing!
Inspiring!
Self-confident!
Encouraged!
Learning!
Joy!
Interesting!
Yeah! Interesting!
Appreciative!
Creativity!
Funny!
Passion!
Join in!
Incredible.
Insightful.
Inclusive.
Cheers.
Music.
Unique.
Learned.
Challenging.
Top notch.
Experience.
Joyful.
Marvelous.
Inspiring.
Happy. Challenging.
Life changing.
Awesome.
Brilliant.
Helpful. Great.
Elevating ever.
Loving it.
Rekindled an old flame.
Hopeful.
Privileged.
Engaging.
Fun.
Exciting.
Fun.
Holistic.
Spiffing.
Motivational.
Spiriting.
Motivating.
Beneficial.
Transformational.
Excited.
Inspirational.
Uplifting.
Creative.
Community.
Inspiring.
Sensational.
Enthusiastic.
Thank you so, so much.
Informative.
Adding hairpins.
Inspirational.
Opportunity.
Unity.
Happy.
Revitalizing.
So much fun.
Stimulating.
Influential.
Dynamic.
Really nice.
Awesome.
Exciting.
Amazing.
Motivational.
Valuable.
Stimulating.
Interesting.
Delighted.
Artistic.
Fun.
Cool.
Expressive.
Amazing.
Great.
Fun.
Enjoyable.
Brilliant.
Motivating.
Inspirational.
Colourful.
Uplifting.
Inspirational.
Joyous.
Fun.
Agnes Barcel.
Exciting.
Challenging.
Educational.
I feel alive.
Inspirational.
Encouraging.
Really inspiring.
Tickled pink.
And so rewarding.
Spectacular.
I really, really, really love the Benedetti Foundation.
Now it's hard for me to adequately find the words to thank sincerely and deeply enough the team of tutors that have provided you all with such unbelievable substance, that have taken such genuine and heartfelt care over what to tell you and how to tell it to you, over the time and consideration they invested in trying to provide you with the best possible experience. It's an overwhelming feeling for me to have a collective of people all humbly doing their bit and working together, but each individually be so endlessly fascinating and uplifting and enlightened and kind-hearted and giving. So we have prepared a little surprise for you.
Thank 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 you.
To To every single one of you that have been part of our Zoom sectionals, you will have all met our ambassadors. They are young students themselves, but have given so much time, dedication and energy to this project. They have recorded single line tracks for you. They have sat on Zoom sectionals and answered all of your questions. They have gone above and beyond to be a help to you, to be your big brothers and sisters. And I think they also deserve an enormous thank you. To try to determine how a piece of music makes you feel is sometimes a very exposing experience. It can sometimes be an uncomfortable experience, but it's always a questioning and searching experience. And leading that part of our connection to music over the last few weeks has been one of the most genuine and beautiful people, Lucy Drever.
Thank you so much for all your amazing creative responses. The pictures, the videos, the drawings, the poems. It's just been completely overwhelming. And on behalf of all of us, thank you so much for getting involved, for taking the time to get involved, but also to take the time to get creative with the story. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
One of our dearest teachers, friends and musicians, Robin Michael,
has been taking us through the most incredible harmony workout throughout the last 3 weeks, and we have all learned so much from him. But he has also been coaching our participants on improvisations based on a motif from the Thomas Tallis Fantasia. We have learned a lot about modes from Robin and a lot about moods from Lucy. So we're going to hear a little bit of those two put together now.
Fantasia. Soft, mysterious, taunting, still. It swirls between centuries, painting faded memories while conjuring tomorrow's dreams. This time, peacefully, the horse is rearless again.
Now to our final piece of music. We've had the honour of being conducted over these weeks by Karina Canellakis, a great friend of mine and one of the world's leading conductors. She made the decision early on to not use any time-guiding equipment, be it a metronome or a click track. She recorded the piece into the room, imagining the sound in her mind. That visual recording was then sent to all of our musicians and we pieced it together based on her interpretation. Now, for a lot of musicians during this time, we are purely functional in trying to create music collectively. We wanted to try to take that a step further and create real magic. Slow internal music is very difficult for all of us to play, but for young people it is extremely difficult to play. We decided that the collective result was worth the difficulty, and for young people to be a part of something so pure and so beautiful is something that would remain with them forever. The team at the Benedetti Foundation have worked tirelessly over the last month to make this experience as good as possible in these very, very difficult times. So I would like to call them out by name. I'd like to thank Laura, of course, the director of the foundation.
Without her, none of this would be possible. And I'm sure you can all appreciate the dedication and hard work that she puts in.
I would like to thank Fiona, who has been replying to so many of your emails and questions. I would like to thank Scott, who is responsible for everything that you see on camera. I would also like to thank Ashby, who has been working alongside Scott, putting all of our materials together and working on film and audio content. I would also like to thank the extra assistance that we had, totally invaluable. So thank you to Emily, to Maeve, and to Lindsay. I would like to say thank you to Hannah, who is responsible for everything you see, all of our timetables, posters, adverts. I would also like to thank Rebecca, who officially takes care of all of our PR, but does so, so much more. As you can imagine, the pulling together of the sound of hundreds of different musicians is quite a task. And for that, I would like to thank Jonathan and Simon, our producers and sound engineers. I would also like to say a second thank you to Ashby, who was responsible for doing exactly that job for the Paganini. Music like this does not need a lot of words to introduce it or explain it, but I would like to offer a thought to you that the knowing that people from all over the world are watching this collectively, that can give us cause for reflection that's both encompassing of the shared experiences in the world that we all have and of our very own personal and very internal life. Two perspectives are never the same, and yet we all share so, so much and have shared so, so much during this time. So I invite you into a moment of contemplation and reflection. We are all together. Thank you.